didukung oleh.
Pemirsa, Anda kembali lagi. Kita masih berbincang-bincang seputar Global Youth Forum. Saya masih bersama dengan Executive Director of UNFPA, Dr. Bapak Tunde Osho Timehin. Dr. Bapak Tunde, now we are focusing about Global Youth Forum itself. So who will be participating in this forum?
These are young people selected by themselves.
Mm-hmm. In a way?
By themselves. Okay. The governance mm-hmm. of the forum is by young people. Mm-hmm. And they actually went out online and asked people to apply and selected their peers to be able to come to the Global Youth Forum. So this is by young people for young people.
Okay.
I think that's, for us, it's a first in the United Nations. And we're very excited by that because we must walk the talk. If we say that young people should be responsible for themselves, must allow them to do so.
How many countries that will be joining?
This would be like just about every country mm-hmm. in the United Nations. And we expect I think we have registered about 700 people already. Mm-hmm. But more importantly is that we'll have what we call World Cafes, mm-hmm. which is an electronic platform that enables young people all over the world to dial in, to be able to communicate, to be able to participate in the okay. conversation, so that we have an enriching conversation, not just with those who are physically there, but those who can join.
So this is not just about the 700 participants,
but it's about
the young people around the world. You also have a Twitter. I follow your Twitter already.
Yes,
you know,
yes.
Always talking about young people.
Because women. I believe that young people is now and the future of the world.
Okay, so from the 4th December until the 6th December, what are they going to do, these young people?
They're going to have thematic discussions. They're going to have, informal mm-hmm. discussions. They're going to be talking about their development, their education, their health, you know, participation in society, participation in politics, you know. They're going to be talking about the reproductive and, you know, health and reproductive rights. So it's going to be a whole range of discussions they're going to be talking.
So it's more about discussion in a way,
the idea, and all the stuff. Ideas to generate and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we hope that at the end of the day, on the 6th, they will have a statement mm-hmm. which would be available to all of us to enable us, you know, program better.
And they're representative of their own country, right? So they can speak about their country.
They're representative of themselves, actually, okay. not of their countries, of themselves. But of course, because they derive from different countries, they'll be able to speak about the experiences of their own countries.
So how do you see this Global Youth Forum to Indonesia, in a way?
I think it's a good thing. Indonesia is a most welcoming country, very warm, very hospitable people. And I think also the government of Indonesia had also agreed to participate in this, so they are part hosting this forum, which is good for us. It sends a right message to the world that Indonesia is taking its rightful place mm-hmm. in terms of leadership in the world, and I think that's a very important thing. Indonesia is not just a leader in Asia Pacific. Indonesia is a global leader, and I think That is what this signifies.
But the young people that will come to the Global Youth Forum will be the next leader, in a way.
Well, some of them are already leaders now, so it's a question of, you know, making sure that we give them the space to express themselves.
So what is your hope for this forum?
What I'm hoping is that we would have new ideas to enable us to engage better with young people. They will be able to see themselves and their aspirations met going forward. And I think that's very important. You see, if you look at the world today, and let me give some figures. Last year, on the 31st of October, we had 7 billion people in the world.
Mm.
1.8 billion of them are young people.
Mm.
Most of them are in the developing world. 48% of the population of Indonesia is less than 24 years old. In many countries in the world, 70% is less than 30. So you're talking about a huge number of people mm-hmm. within these countries that are young. Now, of course, if you follow what has happened in other parts of the world, young people have been asking to be included. They've been asking to participate. They've been asking for understanding of what's going on. The Arab Spring is one thing that you will see. So I think that we should proactively go out to them and get them to tell us, you know, what they want. What's the future they want? What is the world they
want?
How can
we support them?
How can you support them? How can we give them space to express themselves, meet their aspirations? Because, you see, the aspirations are very different from what we think they should be doing. You know now that they speak to themselves not through the Times or the newspapers or through television. Mm-hmm. They speak to themselves in Twitter, Facebook, Foursquare. That's a new generation. And we need to capture what they're saying. We need to capture how we can transform that energy into constructive engagement and constructive development of our countries.
Okay, so after this Global Youth Forum, what is the next agenda? It's not going to stop here, right?
No, certainly not. Certainly not. After this, we are going to just take what we have and try to put it in a larger context of development. Mm. That's the first. UNFPA, the United Nations Population Fund, has a unique opportunity, for example, that we're leading the interagency, that is within the United Nations, the interagency platform for youth development. Mm-hmm. So we're going to take this and use it for that agency in terms of programming, in terms of trying to do what we have to do. One thing that is so striking, and I think maybe that's why Indonesia decided to host it, is that the president of Indonesia actually knows and appreciates and wants young people to be given the opportunity. So we're going to also present this outcome to him. So, governments can begin to take this and run with it. One other thing is that the president is one of the three in the world that is leading the global agenda for the post-2015. And I think that also fits into that. So we have many opportunities and many avenues to give expression to the things that the young people are going to do in Bali.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
You're flying this evening, right, to Bali?
Yes, I am.
Hope you have a safe flight.
Thank you very much.
Enjoy Bali.
I will.
Regards to all the young people.
I will, and I will tell them that they should watch out for the 6th, because you are speaking for them. You're younger than me, so I'll expect that you're one of the young people and that you represent them. Thank you so much.
Ya, pemirsa, demikian wawancara saya dengan Dr. Babatunde Osho Timehin. Semoga ini bermanfaat untuk Anda, yang pasti kita dukung semua gerakan untuk mendukung generasi muda ke depannya, terutama di Global Youth Forum. Sampai jumpa.
Ya, dan kita jeda dulu pemirsa, kami masih akan kembali dengan informasi ekonomi dan bisnis yang akan disampaikan oleh Lucia Sahari. Tetap di Wireshark.
Didukung oleh